In the beginning, they were simply server licenses. You would buy a number of servers, hardware boxes, and you would put software on them, and you would license them per instance. And some of the products still retain the same licensing model. You license them per instance, per server, essentially. And how would you scale that? You would buy more servers, therefore you would buy more licenses. And then at some point, some clever people said, why don't we scale horizontally? Why don't we add processes to the same server? And therefore a new thing appeared, more powerful servers, which did not require additional licenses. Software vendors thought, we're losing revenue. If they're not buying more servers, we're not selling more licenses. So they decided to switch some of the products to per processor licensing. Therefore, each of the two processor servers on this diagram would require now two licenses per server. But the progress didn't stop there. At some point again, some clever people decided, why don't we scale the performance of the servers by adding processor cores? Effectively, adding new processor cores is like adding new processors, almost like that. So how do you scale now? You put more powerful processors in the server, and therefore you don't need to buy new servers, you don't need to add new processors. And then software vendors looked at that and said, we're losing revenue. Again, let's charge them per core. And this is how we ended up with the core metric. So now to license a server, you need multiple, several core licenses, and there are some minimums in Microsoft licensing. For example, you need at least 8 cores per processor for Windows Server, and at least 16 cores for the entire server. You can't buy less. The server won't be licensed. And the last thing I need to mention when we're talking about cores is that there are also virtual cores. Virtual cores, usually in VMware and Hyper-V, are representations of hardware threads. They sometimes can be called virtual CPUs. They sometimes can be called virtual cores. In Microsoft licensing, you need to count virtual cores, the smallest fraction in the virtual machine. And there are also, for some products, minimums per virtual machine.